see.
You gotta cut out the first one, by the way.
Yeah.
It's meant to be. It'll be. It'll be.
Me too, like, no.
Thank you.
Hi. Thank you so much. Yee! Hey! I love it. This place is so good. McDonald's. Ryan, how do you rate this? Did you like it?
It's a freaking 15 out of 10.
15 out of 10, hey! Yes, sir.
Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. And today's video is something special. I'm here with my guy best friend. He needs to get in.
Hi, guy. Oh, it's like that's every day we're together.
Okay, yeah, okay, I'm good.
I'm Ryan. Let me speak.
Ryan, and today.
Oh my god.
First video together.
Hey Ryan, hey Ryan.
Oh wow.
Anyways, I'm Ryan, and in today's video, we'll be reading scriptures and reflecting on it.
Let's go right into this video. Let's get it! Okay. Woo!
Right. Our first verse is 1 Thessalonians 5:11, which states, "Therefore, encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing."
Oh, that hit! That's a good scripture.
So every time Kiana posts a picture, you know her.
Oh, her. Me, I post like way too much. I could just rant about
We're always hyping each other up. Hey. We're just like, slay, F it up.
Yes, work it, you better, okay.
So, in a way, it's building each other's self-confidence. And
yeah.
I think that's very important in nowadays.
In nowadays.
So grab a boy.
Expose yourself.
Nowadays, I mean, not in nowadays, nowadays.
Yup. And I feel like I don't get why people want to tear each other down. When you should just motivate each other, or if you feel that way, then just don't say it, because
exactly.
There's only nice things that you should say that come out of your mouth, basically.
Because not everyone is entitled to your opinion. Your opinion doesn't matter, God's opinion matters.
Amen! Woo! This is why we're the holy duo. But yeah.
Okay, what is the next one? What is your next one?
Oh.
She wasn't ready. She wasn't ready.
And this is on YouTube.
Expose
I am
yourself.
So sorry, guys.
Actually, I'm the one that should be sorry because I have to publish this or upload it.
This is my first video, so.
Yeah.
This excuses is the first. For me. No excuses for you.
Laughing at himself. Okay, I'm not laughing.
We're so bipolar, but.
We are.
That's what makes us close.
You're right, you're
Anyways.
Right. Anyways, hold up. I don't know my scripture yet.
Let's get it, Paula Ann.
You guys don't know why he said that because that's my middle name. Just
They didn't ask, I believe.
Yeah, but people want to know. Actually, they don't because you said it. It came out of your mouth.
Okay. Okay, let's get it. Okay.
Let's get it.
Next scripture.
Okay, so Isaiah 41:10. I like scroll down.
where is it?
Right there, I okay, he got it. Okay. It says, "So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand."
Can we get an amen?
Amen! So I like that verse or like scripture because basically you shouldn't fear anyone but God. Like, you shouldn't fear like society or how people look at you, because you should just know that God placed you in this life. Like, we wouldn't have this life if he didn't die on the cross for our sins.
Yes,
and
exactly.
He pretty much, yeah, he just,
like in the verse says, it says, "I will strengthen you and help you." God will always be there to uphold you whenever you're down. He just always be there, the only one you can ever count on.
Yes, yes, yes.
Through your best and toughest times.
Oh yes, amen.
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 Woo, yeah. Sorry if we don't make sense. Like, we're just talking.
Yeah, this is just how we actually come.
We're from Hawaii. Level of education, so.
Yeah, she's not kind. And what I just said, that's like pigeon. Or molk or what. Yeah, see, I don't even know sometimes because low education.
Ooh, I like this one. So our next verse would be Psalm 55:22.
I'm trying to find it.
Which states.
Where it at though? Oh, I don't know where it is. Okay, I guess. Wait, wait, wait.
It's like literally right below yours.
What?
I don't know why you're scrolling.
All the way to the bottom. There's only ads now. Really?
Wait, where's the 4110?
I don't know.
Oh!
It's zoomed in. Okay. What is it? 55? Right below? We're like right. 5 down below. We're like 10.
Sorry,
oh.
There.
Okay. Go ahead.
Anyways, back to the scripture that I talked about like 5 minutes ago.
Sorry.
Psalms 55:22, which states, "Cast your cares on the Lord, and He will sustain." Oh my God!
I love that.
Please,
we'll see how I feel if I'm feeling like a good friend. The way he actually reads. Okay.
Anyways, Psalms chapter 55, verse 22, which states, "Cast your cares on the Lord, and He will sustain you. He will never let you." Let you
read or what?
Sorry, Kapolei education. That's why.
Oh, Kapolei education. Change. Yeah.
Psalms chapter 55, verse 22, which states, "Cast your cares on the Lord, and He will sustain you. He will never let the righteous be shaken."
Oh.
So, in my opinion, I'm seeing this as let go and let God, basically.
Yeah.
Like, never worry. Expect Him to do the most. Well, not necessarily do the most work and the most. No, expect. No, that's yeah. Like one of the things he, what do you call that? Erased this part because I'm like, you know, I'm like speechless right now, but.
Yeah.
So just expect and trust in the Lord.
Yeah.
You know, He works in His mysterious ways and never fails.
True.
No matter how long it takes, you just need to be patient.
Yeah.
He will get to you.
Yeah. I feel that same way because you should trust His process.
Yes.
And the part where it starts, the verse, it says, "Cast your cares on the Lord and He will sustain you." I feel like that means you should just put like all your trust in Him and what He does for you. Like, you should be appreciative of that, and you shouldn't care what like others view what you want to do in life, but only God, because He cares about you the most and He's the one that got us here, basically.
Yes.
So yeah, that's how I feel about it. And I gotta find my verse, but let me scroll.
He's over here looking for another verse.
Oh, he's always prepared. That's what I should be doing. I just keep thinking about my thoughts about
I should have did that one.
Do it after mine. Oh my gosh, yes.
I'm actually gonna do that one.
You should, yeah. Oh my gosh,
it's literally like in this.
Oh, okay.
I don't even know.
So the next verse that I found was from Isaiah 26:3. "You will keep in perfect peace those who mind whose wrong. I already read it weird because like you know I said 26:3 after I said 3 again. 26:3. And the verse. Oh my god, and the verse. And the verse. Dying over there. It's chapter
Isaiah. You were about to say Isaiah.
I was gonna say chapter Isaiah.
Yeah.
Ah, why did I stop? Okay.
You're going good. Like, for real.
The next scripture that I have is from Isaiah chapter 26:3. States, "You will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are steadfast." I don't know.
You know what? I'll read it on behalf of her. So this is found in the book of Isaiah, chapter 26, verse 3. "You will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are steadfast because they trust in you. So proceed with caution, Kiana Akano."
Okay, Ryan Chenan.
Okay.
"You will keep in perfect peace." Yeah, so I feel like the part where it says "you will keep in perfect peace," I feel like that's why God teaches you how to forgive people. And when you forgive someone, it just brings peace to your heart, basically. And I mentioned that in the last video I had.
Very well put.
Oh, thanks! Yeah, because like honestly though, when you forgive someone, it just takes off that grudge, basically.
Mm-hmm.
And like the bad terms that you had with someone.
Mm-hmm.
And when you forgive them, you basically move on for yourself and your heart just feels like it's open and you don't have that like,
yeah,
that guilt or any stuff like that, like frustration or negativity, basically. Yeah, that's how I look at it.
I agree with you. I feel like holding a grudge against someone is just a waste of time.
It is.
Like, you're just holding their actions into account.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Like, do you know what I mean, though?
Yeah, and like you're holding yourself back too, when you could be like.
Yeah, like you're so focused on their imperfections, you're like not really concentrated on yourself and like how you need to be building yourself in ways of the Lord.
Yep, exactly. Exactly. That's why I like that quote, because like the part where it says perfect peace, that's really like, it hit me. Like perfect
and
peace.
And she is a very positive person, so.
Oh, thank you. I want to be peaceful or whatever.
Okay, guys. Oh. Next verse is found in the book of Peter. So this one is 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7, which states,
go ahead.
Cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. This one holds a lot of meaning to me because I personally have anxiety, and it's honestly hard to live with because I have really, like, well, how do you say it? Like,
it's
like, my parents don't really understand my point of view.
Yeah.
Like, I don't really look for the good in situations. I take more.
He like prepares himself for the worst, but usually like that doesn't happen.
Yeah, basically. So sorry, I'm really speechless
like,
right now.
No, it's really like a hard topic to talk about when you really go through like your whole life. Because I didn't have like super bad anxiety, but I did have social anxiety. But I
social anxiety
that really
is the
anymore.
Worst.
Yeah, that's really bad. But when you feel like no one's accepting you the way you are, then that's what really
it's a really a lot of pressure.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
And it urges you to do things that aren't normally what you do, like.
Mm-hmm. Like you're like, that's not the person.
Like
that
you're so focused on building yourself into someone you're not.
Yeah.
But it's also hurting you because it's not you.
Oh. And,
you know.
Yeah. It's like there's a part of you that you're like. It's like.
Sorry, we're getting so deep into this.
I know this sounds depressing, but I promise we're not depressed. We're actually doing good. Oh, but yeah, that's how we thought about that, because anxiety.
Okay, moving on to our last verse.
The last verse that I got, or last scripture. Oh my gosh. Oh, well, I don't know. I didn't choose one yet. I'm always not prepared. I really like this scripture because it's John chapter 16, verse 33, and it states, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. Peace again, yeah, I like peace. But anyways, in this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. That is so powerful,
beautiful,
right?
Well put written.
Oh my gosh, I love
well put written. Oh my god, grammar again.
This is what happens when we graduate and like a month out of school.
Oh my god, I need to move already. But it's just a really well written scripture verse.
It is.
That like, holds a lot of meaning too.
Mm-hmm. It's everything, like the way it's put, right? Like when you read it, it's just like, wow, it just opens your eyes. And since it talks about peace again, I really like that word peace because I feel like that's just like a light and like positive word, word again. And when you have peace in your life, basically you just feel free and you can feel alive. I know that might sound like cheesy or like corny, but it's true. When you have peace in your life, it's like you have hope at the same time. And you hope for like, there's always gonna be better days when things aren't going good. So when you have peace, you'll have like that positive mindset basically, and you just keep on pushing forward and persevering and getting through life in that positive way. Yeah.
How would I reflect on this verse? I see it as, the world you will have trouble. Take heart, I have overcome the world. So when God says, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace, I see it as looking to him for peace, so that you feel at peace, you know?
Yeah, that's so true, actually.
And
he provides.
Honestly, like, conversating with God is one of the best feelings in the world. Like,
it is. You should really pull out that quote that you have on your phone about that. When you're like, you can have a God conversation, that one that you just sent me last night.
Okay, I sent this so I can look on our message.
Yes, yes. We send a lot of like quotes to each other or anything, especially little Bill quotes. But that's like irrelevant. So he's looking for all the quotes that we have in our conversation, basically. And it's kind of a lot, so if it takes a while, then that's why.
2,000 years later. 6.5 hours later.
Okay, so I found the quote after like, how much minutes?
Wait. Later. 6 hours later. Several bad puns.
I don't know.
Anyways,
it's been a minute.
It says, when you cannot sleep at night, have you ever thought maybe it's God saying, we need to talk and now you have time? That really stuck out to me. I know this is not a scripture verse, and this video is supposed to be about us reading scripture verse, but this is a quote, and it's a godly quote, and I will reflect on this.
Yes, sir, you better. That's what I'm talking about.
Anyways.
Let me just hook you up
too. Honestly, it just stuck out to me because I do have a lot of sleepless nights, especially because of my anxiety. I tend to overthink a lot of things, and my mind would still be running at night.
Yeah.
So it just made me realize, it's sad that technology made me realize that, but sometimes you gotta learn somehow.
Yeah,
some way.
Yeah. And technology, it's like a part of our lives, honestly. Mm-hmm. Like, it's, I feel like it's inevitable because a lot of things work around technology.
Yeah.
And that's just how our generation, or like nowadays, it is. And we're just, it just has to be a part of our lives. I mean, it doesn't have to be, but it's there, so it's pretty like convenient to use, basically. And yeah, I feel like that's a good quote, though.
It is.
Even if it's not a scripture. It's from what? Sprinkle of Jesus, yeah.
Sprinkle of Jesus, yes.
Yes. So, it's really powerful. We always talk at the same time.
Anyways, as I was saying, 5 minutes ago.
2 moments later.
Okay, I guess I can yell too.
Okay, we gotta edit that part out. Anyway.
No.
But anyways, it just really stuck out to me because I noticed that as I started conversating and communicating with God more at night, well, on my sleepless nights, I went to sleep at peace. I wasn't always thinking negatively.
That's
like,
so good.
I found peace with myself, and that is honestly the best feeling to have, especially with having anxiety.
Yeah, for sure.
And it's just a big relief. And I'm saying and a lot.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, is this like college or something? But don't exist.
And I'm sorry, guys. And no.
Don't be sorry. What is this video about? It's about you and me in it.
I just found peace, and that's all I ever wanted.
And I'm so happy because I've known him for the longest of time, basically.
Thank you. That means a lot.
Oh yeah, of course. And to see like his growth, it's really like, wow. Like, I knew he could get there. It's just, I'm glad he did it by himself. But of course, God helped him. But like, it was his choice. Like, he actually, I could cry saying this. Oh my gosh, I'm getting emotional. But yeah, I'm really happy that you come this far and our friendship.
Thank you.
Also, yeah, of course.
Can I edit that part?
No.
If this is God's plan, expect that he will follow through with it. You are where you are for a reason.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that spoke to me, man.
We started sharing our experiences together. We've noticed, like, as we're growing closer to God, our friendship has also
grown closer to each other because of God. Like, because, I don't know, it's hard to like explain, but we both like matured as people, and
yes, definitely.
Yeah, we matured as people, and through everything that we've been through, we always had that bond.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
God. Like,
God has molded
us.
The bond.
Yeah, he molded it. He has that in his notes. So while you remember that,
I have that in my notes.
He got it down. But yeah, that was really like, it's all God, everything that's been happening in our lives. And I can't thank him enough. Like, I can thank him as much as I want.
All glory to God.
I need to. That's like, yeah, amen. And yeah, we just wanted to share our experiences in life and
some scriptures that have actually helped us through life.
Yeah, it touched our hearts. And at this point in our life, we can say that we're actually happy.
Yes.
And life is good.
Definitely.
Oh, it's amazing.
And it's hard for me to say that I'm happy. So the fact that I am actually happy means the world to me.
I know.
This is the best feeling. And
oh,
I would want anybody to. Even my worst enemies, I want them to have this feeling too.
Yeah, like I hope the best for anyone in life. If I know you or I don't, like I want everyone to be successful. And I hope like one day, if you don't believe in God right now, I hope you do. Like, I hope he comes into your life one day, because when he does, it's just the best. Like, it's hard
it's
to explain.
It's a good change.
Yeah,
it's
a change that's great, and life change. Oh my God, it's the best. It's the best change, basically. Because God is the best at everything he does for anyone. And yeah. So, thank you guys for watching this video, and I hope you guys liked my guy best friend Ryan.
Hey.
We talked a lot, and we kind of I like the same person, but in like different bodies.
And different genders.
That's what I meant, not different bodies. Obviously different bodies, we're different people.
Get it.
Anyway. That part I don't do because I'm different. Okay, yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, whatever you want basically. And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys. Comment if you want him to be in another video. Cause I don't mind you being in another video.
Nobody's gonna comment. Nobody's gonna comment.
Cause I don't have viewers. But yeah, bye guys.
Bye.
Thank you.
Mahalos.
Hey. Just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you. I'll find you. I'll find you. Just hold on and I'll find you. I'm hanging on by a thread, and all I'm clinging to is prayers. And every breath is like a battle. I feel like I ain't come prepared. And death's knocking on the It's pressure. Get better, get better. I'm working on switching them letters. But tell I can feel you coming from a mile.